Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on fault code P0172, symptoms, causes, and diagnostics. DTC P0172 indicates that the fuel system is too rich, specifically on bank one. This is very similar to fault code P0175, which indicates the fuel system is too rich on bank two. So basically, this video applies to both of these engine codes, P0172 as well as P0175. And ultimately, what this code is indicating is that the air fuel ratio is too rich on the respective bank. And that basically just means there is too much fuel relative to the amount of air. So it doesn't necessarily mean that the engine is injecting too much fuel. It also could be a lack of airflow. So the fuel flow essentially could be normal and you're just missing out on airflow, or vice versa. So you could actually have proper airflow and just too much fuel flow. With that being said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some common symptoms associated with fault codes P0172 and P0175. Some of the most common symptoms are going to include poor fuel economy, power loss, most importantly, the check engine light. Anytime the computer triggers a fault code, that should also trigger the check engine light, rough idle, as well as strong fuel smells from the exhaust, and potentially black smoke from the exhaust. Black smoke with a rich condition is much more commonly associated with diesel engines, so something to keep in mind there. And one last symptom that can be a little bit harder to notice without testing is oil dilution with fuel. So if you do have rich conditions, more of that unburnt fuel can actually mix with the oil, causing oil dilution with that fuel. And so ultimately, that's going to be hard to detect without any kind of oil analysis or potentially changing the oil and noticing that it has an overly gassy or fuel-like smell to it. Now, ultimately, I know that was kind of a wide range of symptoms, and it is true that any sort of fuel system too rich code can create a wide range of symptoms. And really, the exact symptoms and the severity of those symptoms really depends on the exact air fuel ratios and just how rich the engine is running on that bank. With those common symptoms out of the way, let's jump in and discuss some of the most common causes of P0172. As I mentioned in the introduction, in its simplest form, the cause of fault codes P0172 and P0175 really boil down to either a lack of airflow or too much fuel flow, or a combination of the two things. So it can be something airflow related or fuel system related triggering the P0172 system too rich fault code. Looking at the specifics, a few of the most common causes of these fault codes, starting with airflow first, are going to include the mass airflow sensor as well as your air filter. There are also the oxygen sensors that can trigger fault code P0172 or P0175. And then more specifically on the fueling side of things, any sort of high or excessive fuel pressure or potentially leaking fuel injectors can trigger these fault codes. Those are a few of the most common causes. There are a couple other things that can cause it. And again, really anything restricting airflow or causing too much fuel to enter the cylinders can trigger these fault codes, but the ones I just went through are some of the most common causes. That said, with the symptoms and causes out of the way, let's go ahead and jump into actually diagnosing fault codes P0172 and P0175. Step number one, if you've landed on this video and know that you have this fault code, you've probably already done this step, but use an OBD2 scanner, read the fault codes, see what codes are stored in the ECU, and you can use those codes as a good starting point. For example, if you're getting P0172 alongside codes specifically pointing to the oxygen sensors, or maybe something pointing to something in the fuel system, you can use those codes to help put them together and point you in the right direction of what the actual issue is. Moving on to the second step, always start with the basics. Things as simple as the air filter or mass airflow sensor can trigger fault codes P0172 and P0175. With the basics, check the air filter, make sure it's not too dirty or nothing's clogged in there. Check the intake tract and piping around the filter to ensure that all the connections are proper and nothing's loosely fitting or disconnected. And then check the mass airflow sensor, ensure that's connected. Same thing with the O2 sensors, that the O2 sensors are all in place and there isn't any visual damage. Essentially, just ensure nothing obvious is out of place, damaged, loose, disconnected, dirty, etc. Once you've done that and notice that nothing obvious is standing out, moving on to the third step, it's a good idea to knock out some of that basic maintenance. Maybe the air filter didn't look terribly clogged, but it is a little dirty and you know it's due up for service. It's a good idea to just go ahead and replace that, even if it's not the issue, that's good maintenance to knock out. Same thing with the mass airflow sensor. Go ahead and pull the mass airflow sensor, clean that sensor. Even if that's not the root cause, that's still a good maintenance, still a good step to take and knock out the stuff that's very cheap or essentially free to do. So ultimately for step three, just go ahead and replace and clean a couple of those cheap, simple air filters, sensors, etc. And at that point, if that still doesn't clear this fault code for you, then it is going to be time to either go to a repair shop or do some more advanced diagnostics depending on your capability with DIYing and tool availability. So some other things after that, if nothing obvious is out of place, it's time to test the fuel pressure, check for any leaking fuel injectors, etc. Stuff that can be challenging to do at home unless you are an experienced mechanic or DIYer. But fortunately, when it does come to P0172 and P0175, a lot of the times these fault codes are triggered by something simple, again, like a clogged or dirty air filter, a dirty mass airflow sensor. So a lot of the times, just starting with those basics, checking all of that will help resolve this issue. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.